So we've been doing a lot of factoring in this class. And I'm going to speed through this, so if you want to work on these problems on your own, feel free to hit pause on your browser. But we factored out a common term. We've factored trinomials using two different techniques. Either technique should get you to the same place. We've done difference of squares factoring, difference of cubes factoring, and sum of cubes factoring. So it's about time we might talk about how to use all this factoring that we've mastered to solve some equations. Let's start with an actual example. You might be asked to solve the equation x squared minus 5x minus 6 equals 0. Maybe you don't know how to solve that equation, but one thing we do know how to do is how to factor this left-hand side. In fact, this was one of the examples in the first page that I showed you, and it factors to x minus 6. X plus 1. We'll keep the right-hand side exactly the same. So we're in a very specific situation here. We have terms multiplied by one another on the left side of an equation, and on the right side of the equation there's a zero. What we're allowed to do in this specific case is we can actually split apart the two or more factors that are on the left side of the equation and set them individually equal to zero. So in this case, this is what I mean. We can say x minus 6 is equal to zero, or x plus 1 is equal to zero. We split this one equation now into two separate equations. The first equation is very easy to solve. We just add 6 to both sides and we get x equals 6. The second equation, the same thing. We subtract 1 from both sides and we get x equals negative 1. And those are the two solutions to this original equation up top. Of course, we might still have the question, why are we actually allowed to do this right here? The answer is technically called the zero product property. And the zero product property says that if A times B equals zero, then A is zero, or B is zero, or both. I think that makes sense. How do you get two numbers to multiply together to equal zero? Well, one of them has to be zero, if not both of them. So that's what we're doing over here. We have two expressions multiplied by each other that are equal zero. How is that possible? Well, one or the other has to be zero. And we've used this zero product property along with our factoring skills now to solve an equation. Okay, if you've taken an algebra class, you know that there's always more than one way to solve an equation. In this section, we are only talking about how to solve equations using factoring, so keep that in mind. Okay, here's another example. We want to solve the equation x squared plus x equals 6. And you might just think, well, I'm going to factor. But not so fast. We want to use the zero product property for every one of these problems in this section. So we always want an equation with zero on one side. So the first step we need to do is to get everything on one side of the equation. I'm going to subtract 6 from both sides of this equation, and now we're in a position where we can use that zero product property by factoring. However you factor this, you're going to get x minus 2 and x plus 3 as your two factors. We can use this zero product property now, split it up into two pieces, and each one of those two equations now is going to give us an answer. Every problem in this section is going to go exactly like that. We want to get everything on one side of the equation, do whatever algebra needs to be done to get a factored equation on the other side, and then split up those factors into pieces. Okay, another quick example here. Let's solve x squared equals 4. Get everything on one side of the equation. You'll notice that this is a difference of square. Now we have factors multiplied by one another set equal to 0. We can split it up into two pieces, and we can solve those two pieces for x, and we get our two answers. Again, this is another good time to remind you that we are just talking about solving equations using factoring. While there might be another way to solve this equation, that's not how we're going to do it in this video. We'll do one more example here. So we want to get everything on one side of the equation, so we have a zero maybe here this time. That means we subtract x from both sides of the equation. I'll just leave this term in place. Now this is not an expression that looks friendly to factor, so I'm going to multiply it out first, actually. I distributed the 3x through the parentheses. Now we have a couple of like terms here. Okay, I'm going to make us a little bit of space here. Now we're at a point where we can possibly factor something out of this right-hand side. In this case, just an x. Okay, that's as factored as it gets, but we're allowed to use the zero product property here because we do have two factors multiplied by one another set equal to zero. So the first factor is just x. The second factor is 3x minus 4. This equation is already solved for x. This one we have to do two steps. Add 4 to both sides, divide both sides by 3, and we have two answers. X equals 0 and x equals 4/3 will both solve this original equation up here. Okay, I'm going to cut it off there. Make sure you complete the worksheet for this video, turn it in class, and I will see you all there.